for the ladies.
Hey yo, double M.
And Tyra Smiley. Oh gosh, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, let we make a memory.
Back to the exciting part of the episode where we visit a local boutique and give you guys reasons why you need to come down here and shop. We're at 2121 today, and with me I have the lovely Fleur.
Hi.
Did I say that right?
Yes, you
okay,
did.
Okay, good. So tell us where you guys are located.
We're located at lot 13, 4th and 5th Avenue, Sobrianville, on Shower Street.
Yes, and they have a lot of shoes, and I absolutely love shoes. So I love what they have. So tell people a reason why they should come here.
Well, we have lots of sales. We bring the latest trending clothing. Right now we have buy one, get one free on shoes. We have 75% off select items. We usually bring in new clothes every 2 weeks. We're bringing a new shipment of shoes next week. And so
and you, girl, you and me, chop it to the floor and make me see your energy, because me not play no hide and seek. What is it, the thing you ever make me feel with, girl? Free! Cause anytime you whine and catch it, the selector pull it up and put it for repeat, girl. Me not touch a dollar in my pocket, cause nothing in this world ain't more than what you worth.
I don't need no money.
You worth more than diamond, more than gold.
As long as I can feel.
Sweet memories for the ladies.
Hey yo, double M.
And Tyra Smiley. Oh gosh, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, let we make a memory.
Champion, 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 champion One bag of gold medal pan me now. Champion boy, you know the damn thing. Pan a pour them a singing anthem.
Yellow moon.
Man, man, shell on the goddamn boy. That's why everybody at the champion boy. Have a rich girl in the Hamptons boy. The musha never meet in the champion boy. Now man, I'm gonna sound stars why. Fly the week me at the goddamn boy. Yeah, yeah. Just bust up by a man shot boy. Champion me at the champion boy. Yeah, yeah. I'm on a name, mommy, I'm on a fame, mommy, no need no more driver. Need a money counter, count in get a nine. Sometimes you can't take yourself out. To sell me, me too much of a song and sing my name in the title. Plus I yes, them spend a hour upon the phone and give me financial advice or advice. We some of the mute and never suffer in big girl. If you drunk, then get things go on. I touch a girl, hurt the park. Then you have a mic on a second round, hit me high. Them not bad song, can't lift the Caribbean. Sometimes you wonder how they survive. They did a semi-career sooner than 2 years now. I never feel more alive. Goddamn boy, that's why everybody at the champion boy. So I phone and a Samsung boy. You know, see, see, me at the champion boy. Then I never champion boy. Flight every week, me at the goddamn boy. Yeah, yeah.
So this is Inside 592. Of course, it's the Entertainers Day of Sports, and we're here with the champion. I got my $20 US to prove it. Corwin, how does it feel to be the champion 2 years in a row?
Feels like a champion. Yeah. I feel like West Indies right now. Let me dance.
Champion, 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 champion. Yo, crazy, crazy. So Usain Bolt next?
Yeah, well, I just spoke to Usain. As you know, my sneakers is signed by Usain. Yo. I run in the Puma edition, personally signed by Usain. You know what I mean? So I talked to him later. We got into Olympics.
Yo, I love that. I love that. All right, so you were pulled down. How do you feel about that?
Listen, when I feel the pull or the push, I was already past, you understand?
Yeah.
I was training to run 100 meters, not a 30, not a 60, not a 80. I knew I had to finish 100. You got a good start, but I know with the power and running 100, I would have carried you. Right now I could run 400 meters and I'll breathe the same way. Nothing changed.
So if they're talking about a rematch, would you take him on?
First thing, I have to ask the fans if they want to rematch. Yeah. This thing is not just like that. This thing, you got to work on earning it. Secondly, I have to speak with my team, my trainer, my physiotherapist, my sponsors, because you know a lot of people endorse me.
Yeah.
I don't know if they have other meets to me for the rest of the year. So I have to balance it, you know what I mean? It has to make sense. If not, you have to wait till next year.
And you probably would have to check your schedule, because I mean, you're going to be touring, you're going to be making a lot of appearances and stuff like that.
And you know what I mean? I have some other teammates. And I think that, to be honest with you, I didn't want to give you the raise this year because last year you lost grossly. You know what I mean? Next year, if you have to run, you got to run a few meets. You got to qualify first before you run the champ. You
don't
run
the champ like we're going to money Mayweather him. He
got to beat people. He got to show that he has what it takes to run a champion. And then the fans got to decide if they want to see a loser again. You don't lose 2 years straight. I mean, bring some. I need motivation now. I need to run other people. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I hear you. So all like that run, it's probably going to be like $100 million run.
You know what? I'll do it for charity.
I love that. Anyway, thank you very much. It was the champion, Mr. Corwin Ballers. Shout out your team. Shout out everybody in the background.
Big up to Boogie the trainer. Big up to my wife. Big up to Chanel, who's Raw's wife, who's also part of the team. But she could not have stand it today. She said, I'm flying to New York. Big up to Kevin. Big up to my two kids who come out and work with me every morning. Big up to the team here, the police force, that comes out and makes sure that the champ is in tip-top shape. And shout out to the fans. They know we in Bossy. We just come up to work, and we work. Big up Miguel Riri every time. You don't know we got into Paris for the show. Big up.
Yo, we out for now. Big, big, big talk by Mr. Ballers. Stay tuned for more.
Work every day till we meet ends. Half it on it up on the weekends.
I'm Ashley John, and my show Up and Live is coming to E1 very soon. It's every Saturday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Up and Live, your weekend starts here.
Good time, hey.
Hello, welcome to Car Culture Special Race coverage for the International Race of Champions. As you can see behind me, there are cars on the grid. We're about to get the race day started. The foreign competitors are on their A game today, so it's going to be a great day of racing. So stay tuned, we'll be right back, and we'll give you the first race after this. Tell me how your first race went.
It was a lovely first race, had a good break on the beginning, and we got to the front. We stayed up front, I should say. And realistically, the car worked like a dream, so we came out on top.
So we could see you winning the other races for the rest of the day?
Well, I can't really say how the next races are going to be, because I can't really tell the future. So, but we just hope for the best, and we'll go from there. This machine is capable of doing the job. It may just be me.
All right, best of luck, man.
Thank you.
First this morning. The first race was a very tough one. How is it? How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling a bit bruised and battered because I fell down Friday practice and broke my other bike into pieces. I just barely put together one. Basically, right now, we're thinking about the Caribbean Championship. I'm basically just cruising to the victory right now. Can't go and push and fall and throw it all away. So if I win it within this race, then I'll go and give the crowd something in the last race.
All right, tell me, what position you could go up to secure this championship in this race?
Basically, I just have to get two more fifths. Mm-hmm. That's deadline scenario. And basically, me and Steven will tie in points, and I have the most wins for this year, so I'll be the champion.
Hey! Sweet memories for the ladies.
Hey, yo, double M.
Yeah, but no, we not banana thing anything. Yeah, but cause when we come over there, then we stop. No, we ain't gonna happen.
Hey! Hey! No! I'm back here! Yeah, no, me don't kill me, don't shoot me, please. We are why? I want four. Whoa.
Hey!
Money. Bye.
What do you want?
Hey! Me not paying. Give me your money!
This is a wobbly!
Is it a triple or why?
It's a wobbly!
Oh God, just have a more time for love, me mind. It's not to be belly, mind. It's not even a pain.
Hey!
This is a wobbly!
And this is a good, this is a good gun.
Oh, it's a wobbly, and you got a good gun. Stop my day for me, boy. This wobble people.
Hey,
oh, young boy.
What going on here, boy? Why you laughing, boy?
Hey, it's a wobbly.
What are you skinny with it in a man gun for you? What really happening here?
Hey! Give me your money too!
This is a wobbly!
you just standing up. Say nothing. Say something. Whipped cream.
What a whipped cream!
Hey, whipped cream, let's see your spice. Hey, whipped cream.
Hello! This is a robbery, and I will enter ya seriously.
I will injure you.
Hell, I will injure you.
Hold on.
Customer man.
Hold on. B-man.
Wait. This way, I think I'm joking. This way, I think I'm joking. Yeah, I think I'm joking. Make it listen. I will go and bat the two y'all. Nami.
But
no,
you.
No, I will go and bat you.
Bama. You see you, Mac? You see you, Mac, Bama? If you listen to me and let I do the talking, this would have never happened. But no, you have to be the one for do the talking.
How did this is me for fun? This is you for
fun? But Bambi, look, you ain't nothing right now, Bambi, because if you listen to me and I do the talking, this will never happen. If we get the mask and we add the guns, the real guns and everything, this will never happen. They will listen to me, but no. You, with your speech impediment, cross you. This would have never happened, but you have to be the one for talk.
By how you could disrespecting me if front these people you trying for you make happen by. This is your fault, man.
Hey, this is Gambi, no, me fault. If you listen to me, let I go up, let I do the talking, let I attack them first. But no, you want to attack. No, it is good for you. This way make happen.
This is you for fault, yeah? You think any body does attack you serious? But hello, this is a robbery. Yeah, I feel the joke I'm making. Look, Nami, I will go and put the two of y'all.
Let me go.
John, and I'm the host of a brand new show that's coming to E1 very soon. It's called Up and Live, and it's all about trending topics, foods, drinks, events, places, and so many amazing people. The weekends are made for exploring, and on this show, we're going to be doing just that. Up and Live, every Saturday, only on E1.
For the ladies,
hey yo, double M,
and Tyra.
are outside the famous City Mall on Regent Street. Probably one of the most busiest places, having a lot of traffic, so hopefully we get a lot of people here. I'm gonna go on the cover, my cameraman is gonna be at a distance, and we'll see how this goes down. But I don't know if you guys noticed, but I came swagged out today. My grandmother dressed me, actually. She said I look cute.
So the first thing about getting anybody's attention, whether it's a boy or girl, man or woman, you gotta know how to swag out, right? You gotta make a presence about yourself and have that sort of that aura around you in order to gain attention. So I'm not a pro at that. I'm actually a novice at getting attention, which is kind of weird because I host a TV show. But this is why I recruited my boy Genius over here. Genius, you could introduce yourself to the camera.
Yeah, my name is Genius, Swag Boss.
Genius is Swag Boss. So the reason I recruit Genius over here, who's a local rude boy and swag boss, is to give me a couple tips on how to pose off before we make call off. Because you can't call off without posing off. At least that's what I hear. That's the news around town. So Genius, give me three poses. Three poses, let's do it. There you have it, folks. That's coming, Genius. Genius coming to you live. Genius, big up, respect.
Good afternoon. I can please take you out for puri.
So, how do you feel when you walk in on the road and a man sweet y'all?
I think it degrades you, and it's highly disrespectful to call a woman that, because it reduces you to merely an object rather than a human, because you wouldn't address a human in that way. So that's my.
And what do you think men could do instead of doing that?
Offer better comments like good afternoon, rather than, you know, a nice girl, or, you know, something better. If you want to leave a comment with a woman, do it in a respectful manner.
For the ladies, hey yo, double M, and time. Welcome everybody to a fresh episode of Funky Fridays in the year 2016. We're out with the songs for 2015, and we're in with the new music for 2016. You know there had been a lot of hits last year, but there promised to be way more better hits this year in 2016. So let's start with the top 5 songs on this Funky Friday. Take it slow, but it's not typical. He already knows that my love is fire. His heart was a stone, but then his hands were on. I turned him to gold and it took him higher. But I'll be a daydream, I'll be your favorite things. We could be beautiful, get drunk on the smoke a little weed on the couch in the back room, hide away.
Orange Box, extra, extra, hear all about it. E-Network's Orange Box, everyone is trying to find out about it. 10 free channels, pay one time. No monthly fees, ain't that sublime? Movies, sports, everything you need. So maximize your cable life with E-Network's Orange Box. Everybody wants that brand new Orange Box.
The
orange box is back in stock. Pick it up at Star Computer, Gizmos and Gadgets, NP Electronics, and Electronic City today.
Okay, 592 crew, the next collaboration is infusing dance with speed art. Give it up for Euphoria featuring Winston Alexander.
Lonely, I have nobody. for the ladies.
Hey yo, double M.
And time.
How can we like?
Oh,
not...
yes.
No, you know, Prince Harry.
Yes, the Queen sent the women of the Caribbean an early Christmas present.
But you can only look, you can't touch.
Yeah. Prince Harry's touring the Caribbean and he's gonna stop in Ghana. Actually, he's already here.
He's already here.
Yes, he's already here. They had a beautiful reception at the British High Commissioner's residence. That was absolutely amazing. All the guys from E-Network, they got the opportunity to be there. Hopefully next week we can get some clips or something. We just want to see Prince Harry.
Yes.
Not sure what his other stops are going to be, but he's here from the 2nd to the 5th. So hopefully we get to see him because, you know, he's like the coolest ever. Like, he's not like... What's his brother's name?
William.
Yeah, William's boring and like.
William seems. You have to say that. We
he
can't
seems
say
boring. He seems is boring. Harry's.
Have you met him?
No.
Okay.
Harry.
Have you met him?
No.
Okay.
But he doesn't.
Have you met him?
No.
Okay.
But
have you met Harry?
No. Well, what I can say, Harry seems like the type of guy you can go have a drink with and ask.
Harry, what was the operative word?
Seems like.
I wish we could put. Seems.
Yes. But William seems very fatherly and nice. Like he's
William
run
probably
the
has
kingdom.
A lot of responsibility because he is the elder of the two of them. So he's the crown prince in a sense. So
I guess. Yeah, but Harry's here. I hope you get to see him. I know he was hanging out with Rihanna. That made the news. Like he was chilling with Rihanna and everyone was speculating or whether or not he's going to be smoking weed or he's going to be drinking or just having a ball. Because the last time he hung out with a certain crowd, some nude pictures were leaked of him in Vegas. And Rihanna's not the kind of good girl. She's the kind of girl that will go all out. So she can be like, Harry in Barbados, let's go to all the nasty spots you can think about.
You have to say that in a Bajan accent. Do it again in a Bajan accent.
I was like, I can't do it in a Bajan accent. Harry in Barbados, you go, come with me. Let's go to all the nasty spots right here.
That's actually pretty good. That's actually pretty good. Good impression.
Yeah, so he's in Barbados. He was in Barbados, and now he's in Ghana. So, you know, I really hope I get to see him.
I hope so, too.
E-Network's Orange Box. Extra, extra, hear all about it. E-Network's Orange Box. Everyone is trying to find out about it. 10 free channels, pay one time. No monthly fees, ain't that sublime? Movies, sports, everything you need. So maximize your cable life with E-Network's Orange Box. Everybody wants that brand new Orange Box.
The Orange Box is back in stock. Pick it up at Star Computer, Gizmos and Gadgets, NP Electronics, and Electronic City today.
I know there's gonna be...
Work every day till we meet ends. I fit on it up on the weekends.
I'm Ashley John and my show Up and Live is coming to E1 very soon. It's every Saturday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. Up and Live, your weekend starts here.
Good time, hey.
For the ladies,
hey yo, double M,
and time.
Yeah. Har ladki beautiful kar gayi chul.
Yeah.
Har ladki beautiful kar gayi chul.
That was a rocking performance from our judges, the dashing Jeffrey Iqbal, the ever gorgeous Dr. Vindhya Prasad, and the charming Purnash Durga Prasad. They definitely set the stage on fire. Judges, are you ready for the first elimination round?
I think so. It's not the easiest part, but yes.
I'm quite ready. I think I've been dying to hear what the participants will sing, and I know that the audience is just, you know, waiting.
I'm excited to be back in Guyana. Last year was amazing. I have a feeling this year is going to be awesome. I'm not looking forward to the whole elimination part of it, but I'm definitely looking forward to some awesome music. We've got an awesome cast. We've got great musicians, and it's going to be dope. So get ready for Emerging Voices Season 2. It's going to be killer.
Hey! Sweet memories for the ladies.
Hey, yo, double M.
And time.